In this video, we are going to discuss about passing objects as function arguments in C++. This can also be called as passing objects to functions in C++. Instead of passing value, we can also pass an object as the function argument. Instead of passing an address, we can also pass an object as the function argument. Let's see this example in order to demonstrate how we can pass an object as the function argument. Here we have iostream.h header file. Why? Because in this program we are using cout object. Cout object is present in iostream.h. Next one, class sample. So this is nothing but our class declaration. We know that in C++ the class declaration ends with semicolon. Under the private section we have a variable called a. Next, under the public section, we have defined three functions. The first function name is set, the second function name is sum, whereas the third function name is display. Now let's see the task of set function. Set function is useful in order to assign a value to this member variable a. So void set of, it accepts an integer value. Here we are initializing this I to this a variable. Next we have sum function. So the return type of the sum function is void. All the member functions return type is in this example void only. Here sum function accepts two arguments. The first argument is sample object s1. The second argument is sample object s2. In sum function what we are doing is we are calculating s1.a, we are adding s1.a and s2.a and storing the corresponding result in this variable. So the statement is a is equal to s1.a plus s2.a. We will get perfect clarity while calling the functions. Next we have display function. In display function simply we are displaying a value. Cout less than slash in value of a is equal to less than a. So this is nothing but end of the display function. This is nothing but end of the class declaration. Now let's see about main function. We know that execution of any program starts from the main function. And here we have created three objects. The first object name is S1, the second object name is S2, third object name is S3. We know that whenever an object is created, then memory will be allocated to the member variables of the class. So in this example, we have one member variable. So for S1 object, for A, 2 bytes of memory will be allocated. For S2 object also, for A, 2 bytes of memory will get allocated. Next, for S3 object also, for A, 2 bytes of memory will be allocated. Okay. Next, S1 dot set of 10. So whenever the statement is executed, then the control goes to the set function. So what is the value we pass here? 10. So 10 will be stored in I now. Okay. A is equal to 10. So in S1 object, in A, 10 will be stored. So once this function definition is over, control comes to the main function. The next statement is S2 dot set of 20. So whenever the statement is executed, then the control goes to the set function. Here what is the value? 20. So 20 will be passed to I. Now A value will become 20. What is the object here? S2. So in S2 object, the value of A will become 20. So once the function definition is over, control comes to the main function. So the next statement is S3 dot sum of S1 comma S2. So whenever the statement is executed, then the control goes to the sum function. So this is the concept which we are discussing here. Passing object as the function argument. So here S1 is nothing but an object. S2 is nothing but an object. So we are passing an object as the function argument. So whenever an object is passed, then the entire object, the copy of that object will be passed to the corresponding object. Okay. So S3 dot sum of S1 comma S2. So this S1 information will be passed to this S1 and this S2 information will be passed to this S2. So in S1, what is the content? We have 10. So now what is the statement here? A is equal to S1.a plus S2.a. So what is S1 here? S1 means S1 object contains a variable called a. So instead of that, let us take some other variable. Let it be some O1. Let it be some O2. O1, O2. So here the statement is A is equal to O1.a plus O2.a. So now what will happen? S3 dot sum of S1 comma S2. So this S1 content will be copied to this O1. So what is S1 content? A10. So this will be copied to O1. Okay. Instead of that, let us write the object one more time. So what is the name of the object? O1. So O1 object contains A whose value is 10. So likewise, S2 object will be copied to O2. So what is S2? In S2 we have A whose value is 20. So this information will be copied to O2. So now in O2 we have a value called A whose value is 20. Okay. So whenever this statement is executed, then the contents of S1 object and S2 object will be copied to O1 and O2. So now what is O1? O1 contains S1 content. So what is S1 content? A10. So it will be copied here. Next, what is S2 content? A20. So that will be passed here. Next, O2 content is A20. Next, A is equal to O1.A plus O2.A. So what is O1.A? 10. What is O2.A? 10. So 10 plus 10 means 20. So 20 will be stored in A. 20 will be stored in A. Here we use which object? S3 object. Now in S3 object, in A variable, that 20 will be stored. Okay. Here we are using which object? S3 object. So in S3 object, in A variable, that 20 will be stored. So once that function definition is over, control goes to the main function. So next, what is the statement? S1.display. So control goes to the display function. So value of A is equal to less than A. So in S1A, what is the value? 10. So 10 will be printed. So what is the output now? Value of A is equal to 10 gets printed. Okay. Next, once that display function is over, control goes to the main function. So next statement, S2.display. So control goes to the display function. So here, what is the body? Value of A is equal to, in S2 object, what is A value? 20. So in S2 object, what is A value? A value is 20. So value of A is equal to 20 will be printed. Okay, next, S3.display. So control goes here, 10 plus 20 means what? 30. Okay. So next, S3.display. So control goes to the display function. Cout less than slash n, value of A is equal to, in S3 object, what is the value of A? 30. So 30 will be printed. Okay. So 10 plus 20, that is nothing but 30. Okay. So this is about passing objects as function arguments in C++.